Part of what made that game just so great is how improbable it was to come back. Kent is here now, who also knows about keeping your kids up past their bedtime to watch a game. Hey, Kent.
Bath time was lots of fun, Jana. Yeah. This is a win probability chart created by ESPN Analytics, and it sums it up pretty well. Trailing by 15 points with 5 minutes left in regulation, the Lynx were way down there. The chances of winning, well, it was less than 1%. But because a comeback like that had never happened in the history of the NBA playoffs, of course, history was meant to be broken. In the final few minutes of overtime that followed, the fans, let's just say, they weren't the only ones blown away.
You know a game is special when reaction videos speak as loud as the action on the court. Lynx fans were roaring from a bar of their own to Riverview Theater throughout the team's unprecedented Game 1 comeback. But one video spoke even louder.
Lynx have a little shot. Williams again from the right wing. Got it! Courtney Williams knocked it down! Oh my goodness!
As the play-by-play voice of the Lynx, Wendell Epps had one of the best seats in the house, at least until the last shot.
She gets it to Stewart. Drives in. 1 second. Shoots at the right hand.
So it was funny because the view that I had of like Breanna Stewart's game winner, I thought it went in at first. I think everyone in my section thought it went in because just the way the angle facing that basket.
She missed it! Breanna Stewart missed it! She missed it and the Lynx walk out here with a W!
It's easily the biggest game Epps has ever called, considering he's a 23-year-old play-by-play rookie.
It was absolutely insane. I mean, this is my first, you know, big boy play-by-play job, so to have that opportunity was really cool, and it was just a real experience. I loved it.
That young man, I mean, this is his first year calling WNBA games, and he's in the final.
Charles Holman is on the other end of the spectrum, but the Hall of Fame basketball writer says it's also one of the best games he's ever seen, and he had to watch from his living room.
Well, yeah, I watched in my easy chair, and I was on the edge of my seat, as most people were.
I'm guessing you were not at the edge of your seat after that shot by Courtney.
No, I fell backwards. I fell back like she fell when she got fouled. If they win this one, this will be a very unique championship.
What do you think makes this run special?
This team literally just came together this year. That just shows you the great coaching job of Cheryl Reese, who don't get a lot of credit for what she does, how she can put this team together, and how these players grasp onto her. For professional sports, is very impressive that they just love to play together.
And I just think we have a lot of players that have kind of flown under the radar. Even Nafisa Collier, our best player, is probably the most underrated superstar in any professional sports league.
Feet, faking, turning, shooting, and scoring! Nafisa Collier is phenomenal! 95-93!
And the fact that the Lynx bit back in the Big Apple makes it even sweeter.
Literally every time out, I would see a different celebrity pop up on the Jumbotron.
I'm glad that America got to see the Lynx play if they haven't seen them play all year. That was a fantastic, instant classic, as I tweeted out last night. To see the Lynx be on the front page of the paper today, you don't see that very often. For somebody that's been covering the sports as long as I have, that's something that I love to see, and I love to see that more.
Love to see that more. And oh, by the way, there is a lot more, Jana. That's just game one. You got to dig deep. This could be a five-game series, but let's just hope it's not, right? Three-game sweep?
I won't get into that now. I haven't come down from last night's game, and my nerves are shot. But a shout-out to those two gentlemen, really pillars in the community of basketball at this point. And speaking of, you know, Mr. Holman saying the world got to see it. 1.1 million people watched that game last night. 1.5 million at its peak. It was the largest viewership of a W game one in W history.
Wow. Yeah. And there's more to come.
More to come Sunday afternoon. Thanks so much, Kent.